Here I'm asked to solve this rational inequality. The first thing I like to do is factor these. So I'm going to rewrite this in an equivalent form, x plus 2 squared over, now factoring that trinomial, I'll have x times x is x squared, 1 times 5 is 5, adds up to negative 6 if they're both negative, and then a negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5. So this is an equivalent form. First step is to determine your critical values. Now the critical values are the zeros of the numerator and the zeros of the denominator. So what makes the numerator zero here is x equals negative 2. Okay, that's actually a double root. What makes the denominator zero by inspection here is x equals 1 and x equals 5. Now remember, whatever makes the bottom equal to 0 is a restriction to the domain. So here we have three critical values. Zeros are restriction, are critical values, and restrictions are critical values. Now let's go ahead and make a sine chart. Okay, here's a number line. Now let's go ahead and use open dots here because we have strict inequality. So an open dot at negative 2. Certainly we would use an open dot at those restrictions anyways, 1 and 5. Alright, so here we have four intervals to test. So let's choose some values. When you choose x equals 6, the numerator will be positive. The numerator is always going to be positive because look, it's something squared. Okay, when I plug in 6 into the denominator, I'll have 6 minus 1, which is positive, and 6 minus 5, which is positive. So I have a positive number times a positive number. The result will be positive. And that'll be true for any number in that interval. Okay, let's choose a test value in this interval here. Say 3. Certainly, again, the top is going to be positive, and the numerator is positive. When you plug in 3 here, you get 3 minus 1, which is positive. 3 minus 5 is negative. So I have a positive factor times a negative factor. Okay, one negative like that, the result's going to be negative. And that'll, again, be true for any x value in that interval. So here, let's test 0. 0 is always easy to test. The numerator is positive. Okay, plugging in 0 into the denominator, 0 minus 1 is negative. 0 minus 5 is negative. Okay, and a negative times a negative is positive down there. The result will be positive. And then let's choose a test value in this interval, not shown here, let's say negative 5. Again, the numerator is positive, whatever square is going to be positive. So on the denominator I have a negative 5 minus 1 is negative 6. Okay, so that's going to be negative. And negative 5 minus 5 is negative. So again, 2 negatives makes positive, and that interval will be positive as well. So this is a good one to illustrate that your signs, your pluses and your minuses, don't always alternate. So you really should test all your intervals. So then the last step is to answer the question. Okay, the question is, when is this rational expression greater than 0? In other words, when is it positive? Okay, so looking at my sine chart, I can see it's the results are going to be positive for these x values. Okay, these x values in between there, and also these x values. So those are all my solutions graphed on a number line. Now let's translate that into interval notation. Notice negative 2 is not included. So for this interval we have from minus infinity up to negative 2, not included, round parentheses, union, not included, negative 2, up to 1, round parentheses, union, this third interval here, from 5 out to infinity. Okay, so that's interval notation that represents the shaded region here on the graph, and those are the x values I can substitute into the original that'll make that greater than 0.